Hi, this is John Cullen with GrowingYourGreens.com. Today we have another exciting episode for you, and this is going to be a quick one for those of you guys that don't like my long videos. And this is something very valuable, all right? So here's the thing. I went to my local nursery and got some plants, right? And these are some nice red cabbage plants. But the problem is, when I go to this certain nursery, I'll name the nursery, Star Nursery, the plants are not of the highest quality, and they often have aphids. So look at that. You know, I did get these a little while ago, so the aphids have been basically breeding on there. Like, look at that, all nasty little aphids totally on there, right? And I could make some neem oil and Dr. Bronner's mix it up and spray it or something, or I could sit there with my fingers and try to crush them, but that gets like really messy and ooey and gooey. But I'm going to show you guys an easy way, a quick way actually, to get rid of your aphid problems on plants, whether they're in a pot like this or whether they're in your garden, right? Basically, I just spray them off with water. So this is one before, and here's one after. Look at this one, nice and clean. You could go through all the different leaves and I don't see one aphid or one egg or nothing on there, right? Super simple, super easy. You're gonna only need a few things. So I have a nice concrete mixing tub. This is a large mixing tub, 21 gallons. Home Depot is better than Lowe's to get one of these guys. Then I have a nursery flat. This is an empty nursery flat. We're gonna put this upside down in my mixing tub, because basically this is going to basically be my washing station or catch all the water, so then the water I'm using to spray these guys off I could then reuse to water some other plants, maybe like some trees or something around my property. And then you just need a good high pressure sprayer. So this one actually I got at the dollar store. I don't recommend it because it actually sprung a leak and I had to put some duct tape on it. Duct tape fixes everything, but I basically just have it on the flat, so if we spray it, it basically comes out high pressure, high stream, as hard and as fast as you guys can get it. So what I'm going to do is we're going to go ahead and take this plant, and then we set it on the side right here, set it on its side right here. Then we just take the hose, turn it on, and then I'll just start spraying these leaves down, like the back of each leaf, the front of each leaf, like one leaf at a time. So just spray them off one leaf at a time, get the whole back leaf, get everywhere, get the front of the leaf, the next leaf, next leaf. All right, so I think I got it about done. As you guys can see, I had it on its side, just sprayed off every leaf individually. Make sure you kind of unfurl and unroll the leaves to like totally get in there, and make sure you get all of them. Oh, look, I missed a couple. And especially get the center leaves, that's where they like to live, and then also like to get the stalks and the stems. They'll often hide and live in there. Then basically got a clean plant. What I like to do then is I then take out this little grid. Then I like to take a bucket. I got a 5-gallon bucket here, and we'll carefully lift up this this bin, and we'll see how much water I used to spray down my aphids. Niagara Falls. All right. And now here's all the water we get to use to now water my plants. And I'll probably like water trees. There might be some living aphids in there, so I might like let this sit out for a little bit, let them drown before I use this water. But you know, that's a simple way, by just using water to spray down your plants, you can get rid of your aphid problems forever. Just make sure you get them all, because if you leave one, they'll breed and create more. So yeah. Organic gardening doesn't have to be hard, just need to, sometimes it takes some time, and it's a lot easier to spray off with water, and I'd prefer to do that than even use some kind of organic, you know, pesticide for the bugs. Even Dr. Bronner's and, you know, neem oil, I prefer this method first. If this doesn't work, then I might go ahead and do that later. But yeah, I found this works 99% of the time, provided you get them all. If you guys enjoyed this quick episode, hey, please be sure to give this video a thumbs up. That'll encourage me to do more short videos in the future. Also, be sure to click that subscribe button right down below to be notified of my new upcoming episodes that are coming out about every 3 to 4 days. You never know where I'll show up or what you'll be learning on my YouTube channel. And be sure to check my past episodes. My past episodes are a wealth of knowledge, over 1,300 episodes at this time. Teach you guys all aspects on how you guys could grow your own high quality food at home. So with that, my name is John Kohler with GrowingYourGreens.com. We'll see you next time. And until then, remember, keep on growing.